Namaste, everyone. My name is Dr. Jivan, and my very good friend Satyama can share with you today seeds of beauty of woman nature. And Satyama radiate of happy and joy, and in his presence, everything started flowering. And what is a secret? What do you do in life to produce to produce this quality of energy? Share with us, please.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Jivan. As he said, my name is Satyama, and I have a company on Copenhagen called Open to Bliss, in which I attempt to bring in practices, meditation and yoga, and also awareness about Tantra and true classical Tantra practices, in order to create union, essentially, of the masculine within ourselves and the feminine within ourselves. So sometimes these can be very much out of balance, and we work towards putting this in the center so that we can find the middle way, or the middle path is what it's referred to in when we meditate. And that means not going into the low, 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 and not going into the super, super high, but being able to stay at a steady place so that there is sukha or steadiness in your life, especially in somewhere where there is high energy, such as Copenhagen, and things are always going up and down, and we are constantly changing. What is it that we can do in order to bring a lot of peace into our daily activities? And when we get to a place where that peace might be elevating, how can we turn that into something that's an experience that has a lot of bliss naturally, instead of taking a lot of drugs, substances, whatever it might be to elevate us? How do we use practice and awareness in order to have this bliss? So what I would talk to in the sense of what can women do, because this is really of interest, and our cycles are so varied because we are in alignment with the moon, we have menstruation, and this can cause hormonal imbalances. What is it that we can do here? So I would talk first about yoga, and essentially doing a practice of tantric yoga, which is something that I'm specializing in for women. And one element of tantric yoga, although it's very vast, would be to do subliming work or sublimation work. So things like the technique of retaining the breath out and doing an Uddiyana Bandha suction lock, as I'm slightly attempting to show here, and then dropping the belly, inhaling through the nose, so that there is a channeling that goes on from the lowest center or Muladhara chakra into higher chakras in the body. So this purification can actually happen, especially when stagnant energy is going on with menstruation or with lower energies, it's pulling us down. And when you're doing work with pranayama or with this Uddiyana Bandha that I just referred to, or even turning the body upside down in a yoga pose, so doing something like headstand or shoulder stand, or even having the head lower than the body, will bring a sense of elevation. And so when you're feeling kind of like, my emotions are low, or I've eaten too much food, or I'm, you know, too much on the ground, then just altering this through a yogic practice of any kind. It can be hatha, can be vinyasa, can be tantric yoga. There's so many kinds of yoga, but this essentially a daily practice for at least 30 to 45 minutes can really change this and our perspective. So we keep upping the level of joy, of happiness, of awareness when we practice. And without that, we just kind of stay flat. So up, up, up is kind of the idea to maintain a good control over what's happening in life. The other thing I wanted to talk about a little bit here to introduce this connection of yoga and tantra and meditation is the jade egg. And this is a really big thing on Copenhagen. It's a little tiny egg made out of jade, or could be rose quartz. And women, you might not have never heard of this, but can use the egg inside the yoni. Essentially, in tantric speak, this is the vagina, so that you can tighten these muscles in the yoni and be able also to bring that energy up. And this has amazing, although very subtle, purification effects for women that can really empower women in their healing journey, which women, all women, I would say, are going on a healing journey around sexuality as we are evolving on the planet. And this, I would say, is particularly happening faster on Kopangang. So when the jade egg practice, again, it is a practice, so I'm not going to go into what you do with the jade egg, but simply squeezing, a holding, an awareness, and a speaking to this egg in connection with the yoni and also with the ovaries and someone's entire sexual life can then emanate beautiful sexual energy as you bring it up. So not keeping it down and just going into physicality, but actually using that for love from the heart for anahatic purposes so that you can share this energy and not keep it in the selfless state in which we're trying to come out of self to big picture connection. And that's essentially yoga and tantra being merged. Now, overall, I would say use meditation, any kind of meditation, to bring awareness of slowing the quickness of the human being down so that there is an integrative phase in life in order to be able to see what the real gems are of taking a break, taking space, focusing on breath. Any of these many, many techniques of meditation and styles of meditation, be it from active or vipassana or whatever way you do your meditation, but this essentially can bring in an awareness and a calmness of the mind that we can take so that we stop and breathe. When something happens, we don't react or overreact. We simply be present with what's going on. And this can transform things, especially in women, if they're having an emotional time and it's like, whoa, I'm going to explode here. It's like, actually, I don't have to. I can really be in my own femininity, flowing with what's going on, but not taking a step into the masculine, into action, reaction, or doing something about it. So this is the feminine approach. And just some things that I wanted to talk about first and can go into a little bit more in-depthly with practice, but at least there is a way of using techniques and practices in order to be in the feminine to find balance. So, I'm Satyama again from Kopangang and the World Healing Center, with the whole purpose and idea of healing the planet through the self, and wishing you a great day.